Now that we can find meaningful changes in videos, we can use one of these changes to define an object of interest, a region of interest, and the goal now is to track this object through the entire video sequence. So the first approach we're going to discuss is a very simple approach, which is to use a region of interest as a template and simply apply template matching from frame to frame. As you can imagine, one of the challenges with object tracking is that as this object moves through the video sequence, it can change in terms of scale or distance from the camera, rotation, the lighting can change, and for that matter, the object can even be occluded. It might actually be obstructed by other objects in the scene. So template matching as an approach is only useful for certain simple cases, such as this one right here. Here you're given the location of a target, which is this blue window right here, and we simply want to track this player with the passage of time. And you can see that indeed, by using template matching, you can do a fairly good job. And that's because this is a very benign setting. You have green grass, you have players in essentially two different uniforms of distinct color. So let's take a look at how this is done. We can do template matching in two ways. One is to use the image region itself or the appearance of the object in full to create templates and apply template matching. So that's what's being done here, that you essentially have a template created from your initial image, and you're going to use this to find the object in the next frame and then redefine the template and apply template matching to the next frame. Another way to do this is to use a little bit more of an abstract representation of the appearance, not the direct image itself, but rather, for instance, a histogram. In the case of a histogram, this is a little bit counterintuitive. In the case of a histogram, you actually lose spatial information, but that can sometimes be useful because it makes the method more robust to some of the changes we are trying to be insensitive to, such as rotation and scale. So let's take a look at appearance-based tracking, which is image-based tracking. The idea is very simple. We have done this before in the context of stereo matching. Let's say we define this to be your object of interest, the soccer ball right here with the red window around it. You're simply going to use this as a template and then apply that template within a search window in the next frame. And wherever you get a good match, you're going to declare the new position of the object. And the hope here is that the change in appearance of the object between time t minus 1 and t is very small. So this is a very simple method, and it's clearly not robust to large changes in scale or viewpoint or occlusion. And of course, you can use many different metrics for doing the template matching itself. You can use the sum of absolute differences. We've seen this before. You can use the sum of squared differences, or to make it more insensitive to illumination changes, one might use the normalized correlation as well. Now, the second method is a little bit more interesting, and this is what we'll call histogram-based tracking. Instead of using the image region as a whole, we're going to compute a histogram. It could be a brightness histogram, or it could be a color histogram, a high-dimensional histogram. But that's going to be your template, and you're going to be matching the histograms as templates between images to track the object. So this is how that works. Here you have an object, and we would like to track this object. And one of the things to notice here is that when you have a region of interest such as this, the more reliable points within this region tend to be closer to the center of the region. As you approach the edge of the window, there's a good chance that you might be seeing some background pixels as well, especially as the object rotates and so on. So you can use what's called a weighted histogram. That is, you can weight the contributions of pixels in your window to the histogram differently depending on how far they are from the center of the window. And one such weighting function is called the Eponechnikov kernel, which is shown right here, where the weight drops off as you go further and further away from the center of the window itself. So what does this mean? Essentially, all pixels continue to contribute to the histogram, but the level of contribution depends on where the pixel is in the window. For instance, if you use the center pixel right here, it contributes the full amount, so to speak, a plus one to its corresponding bin in the histogram. But if you look at this pixel off to the edge, closer to the edge, its contribution due to the Epinechnikov kernel is going to be a 0.4 rather than a 1. And so that's what a weighted histogram is. So these weighted histograms are then used to match from one frame to the next. And the rest of it is very much like template matching. And for comparing these histograms, you could use, once again, a correlation, sum of squared difference, or you can use something a little bit more sophisticated like the intersection of histograms. This is a very popular technique that makes histogram-based matching more robust to things like occlusion. So it's a same approach here. Instead of matching the image region right here, you're going to match the histogram of this image region to the histogram of image regions in the next frame. So you go in and find the best match. So this tends to be a little bit more resilient than the appearance-based template matching to changes in object pose or scale or even illumination and occlusion. So let's take a look at how well this works. So this is, again, a sports scenario. You have this region of interest, this player, and you'll see the pros and cons of using histogram-based tracking in that when this person actually crosses somebody with a similar uniform, that is in his team, then you see that sometimes the region of interest gets passed on to another person. So you see right here, everything is working just fine. And then he gets close to one of his players, which is right there, and it gets latched on to somebody else.